Hello and good evening. This is the Daily News Podcast. I'm Navya Singh and here are the most important news that deserve your attention today. Let's get started. Yet another case of alleged custodial torture has surfaced in Tamil Nadu. An auto driver died in a hospital 15 days after he was admitted there following alleged physical torture in police custody. The family of the deceased said that he had been called for an inquiry regarding a land dispute case. They alleged that the police beat him up in custody. After a day of undergoing inquiry, he came back home and didn't speak much. Later, he started vomiting blood and was taken to a hospital. Doctors discovered that his kidney and spleen were badly damaged. It was then that he spoke about the alleged brutality by the cops inside the police station he had been earlier called to over the land dispute case. He also said that he had been threatened by the cops who wanted him not to speak to anybody about what happened inside the police station. They threatened to harm his father. In a major success in the anti-terror operations in Jammu and Kashmir, security forces killed three terrorists, including a commander of the Hizbul Mujahideen, in an encounter in Anantnag district this morning. Apart from the Mujahideen commander, two terrorists were also eliminated in the operation. With this, the police officials have said that the entire Doda district in Jammu region has become totally free of terrorists, as he was one of the last surviving terrorists in that district. After a day's pause, state oil marketing companies on Monday resumed the fuel price hike. Petrol price in Delhi was increased for the 22nd day by 5 paise to Rs 80.43 and diesel prices went up by 13 paise to Rs 80.53. Diesel continues to be costlier than petrol for the 6th consecutive day. The flood situation in Assam worsened further on Sunday, with two more people losing their lives in the natural calamity, which has affected more than 9.3 lakh people in 23 districts. With two more deaths, the fatalities due to the flood this year has gone up to 18. The district administrations, civil defense and inland water transport departments have evacuated at least 9,300 people in the last 24 hours from 5 districts. A 52-year-old doctor at government-run Lok Nayak Jayaprakash Hospital died of COVID-19 at a private facility in Delhi on Sunday. Dr. Raseem Gupta had contracted the virus while on duty early in June. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal on Monday called Dr. Gupta a very valuable fighter. He said that he was known for going out of his way to serve his patients. He said that we've lost a very valuable fighter and Delhi salutes his spirit and sacrifice. Ending the news segment with some good news. Tribal artisans will now be able to sell their products at the click of a mouse, with the government gearing up to launch a specialized e-marketplace for them this Independence Day. A trial run of the e-marketplace will begin on 30th of July and will continue till 14th of August. The objective is to bring around 5 lakh tribal artisans online, thus connecting them to a larger national and international market. That's all for today. I'll be back with some more important news tomorrow. Till then, stay safe, stay logical.